Welcome to ECE 3300, Introduction to Electromagnetics at the University of Utah. In lecture number 7, we're going to be discussing the input impedance. Now, we've already looked at several kinds of impedance, and let's discuss those in general. Here's our transmission line, like this, and it has a characteristic impedance, Z0. So the characteristic impedance, we already know how that is defined. That is V0 plus divided by I0 plus, or it is V0 minus divided by the negative of I0 minus. Z0 is given in ohms. It is a ratio. It's a ratio of voltage to current, but in this case, the characteristic impedance is always either the ratio of voltage to current in a forward traveling wave or the ratio of voltage to current in a negative traveling wave. It is not related to the sum or the total field caused by these two waves. Last time we talked about another impedance, and that was the load impedance. If we consider the load impedance, ZL, that was related to VL divided by IL. Here is VL and here is IL. We can see that VL is the sum of the incident and the reflected waves. So the load impedance represents the ratio of a total field. These are waves that are going in both directions. The input impedance is like the load impedance. The input impedance we're going to call Zn, and that is going to be right here. That's the location of Zn. That is going to be Vn divided by In. Vn is the voltage right here from this point to this, and In is the input current to the transmission line. So there are two basic kinds of impedances that show up in our model. The characteristic impedance Z0 is the ratio of voltage to current for a positive traveling wave or a negative traveling wave, but not the sum of the two. The load impedance ZL is at the load, and that is caused by the sum of the incident and reflected wave. The input impedance is at the input, or the front end of the transmission line. That also is a ratio, and that is related to a summation of the incident and the reflected wave on the front end of that line.